All right, guys, happy Friday. Welcome back, Concepts and Training. Gonna be diving back into training technology, but more so in the velocity-based training. So what this is a GymAware power tool. It's one of the velocity trackers that's out there on the market. Personally, this is one I use, this is one of my favorites. But ways that we can use velocity in our training, right? So when we look at trying to target specific adaptations, we have to consider how those are implemented on the force velocity curve and where on the force velocity curve we're trying to train. If we're trying to train strength and absolute power, well, we're really trying to push the limits on how heavy we can go and being able to kind of assess the how fast we're moving, how much force we're putting into the ground, okay? So when we look at actually developing strength, we can actually try to create a profile on where we start to teeter on how high we can put force in the ground and what the velocities those move at. When we're trying to create speed, obviously velocity-based training, this is really great for developing speed adaptations, right? So basically what you see with a lot of these units, and like I said, the reason I like this one is because this one measures the angle of the lift so you can kind of be forward, backward on it. Basically what we've got is a tether attached to a unit that's gonna track how fast that unit or how fast that bar is moving. So when we look at trying to create adaptations, especially speed, there's two different things that I really like to think about. One is how fast the movement is and what loads we're moving at. So if we can prescribe a specific velocity, whether it's a peak velocity, if it's an Olympic lift or an Olympic lift variation, such as a snatch pull, clean pull, or if it's power clean, a snatch, a jerk even, being able to measure the velocity gives us a more specific adaptation to be able to use those, right? So velocity, so that's more of your squats, your bench presses, your deadlifts, moving in average velocity and what that average kind of velo is, we can start to target specific adaptations, okay? So when we look at adaptations like speed strength, we're really looking at, you know, some of those faster velocities above that, probably 1 to 1.2 meters a second, above that range where we can really start to move fast and create positive adaptations and developing more speed. It's basically moving lighter weights fast. Then we look at like actual power and optimal power outputs. We're probably looking a little bit closer to, you know, 0.9 to 1 meter a second. We can start to try to track that and objectively quantify how fast a bar is moving. Then we can start to get into our speeds, our strength speed. So seeing really, you know, those 0.5 to 0.9 meters a second. At least that's the kind of the way that if you, depending on what research you look at, it's going to kind of quantify that strength speed. When we look at that though, we can start to specifically target adaptations based on how fast a movement is, how fast a bar moves. That's a great tool to be able to have in training. Now, the nice thing about that is that you can basically auto-regulate using something like velocity, because if I take this device and I hook it up to a bar, and let's just say you've had a really crappy weekend, or you know, you and your significant other got in a fight, or the kids are acting up, or you're a college athlete and you've got tons of stressors, you got projects, you got homework. This is going to be able to help auto-regulate, because stress is stress and the body sees stress as stress, so being able to auto-regulate how much load we're going to do based on the velocity. So we keep our adaptation and our speed adaptation the same and developing the same muscular quality without sacrificing, swaying too much to being too force dominant. So that can be a really great way to use one of these tools. So that's one of the main ways I like to use it. The second way, if we really get into then managing volume, is using drop-off points. So we can set targets for velocity, right? And this, like I said, it's one of the reasons I really love this tool, because it's got a very visual interface to be able to see how fast a bar is moving, but it's got a very visual, you can see it as you do reps. It's even got a little like dinging bell feature that you can use to know when you're still in your velocity range. So we can set a target and we can move a weight. Let's just say you're doing a back squat. Well, you might have four sets, and as long as they stay in the rep range or in the velocity range, it doesn't matter how many reps you do, right? You could end up doing four sets of, four sets of reps, and your first set might be six reps. Your second might be three. Your third might be five. Your fourth might be two. But as long as we're in the velocity range, all of a sudden now we've got our volume regulated enough to then say we're in the right velocity range, we're developing the right adaptation. So you can cut off sets based off of dropping out of your velocity range. So that's velocity-based training. That's one of the things that I really like to use, especially when we're trying to develop specific qualities. I use it with weightlifters who need to get stronger. and really pushing, kind of working towards some of those slower velocities. And for those weightlifters, they need to get faster. And then obviously athletes, when you're trying to develop specific phases or like within specific phases, you're trying to develop specific qualities for sport performance. So that's velocity-based training in a nutshell. Those are the two main ways I like to use it, especially because I get a lot of questions on this thing when it pops up in videos or pictures that are on social media. When we talk about using velocity-based training, that's just a brief overview that you can use to kind of understand that concept. And then the main ways that I really like to use it and that you'll see in a training program.